Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Welcome back, Carter. Helaine Lembeck. Richard Dawson. And Betty White. As we play the star-studded big money match game 78. And now, here's the star of match game 78, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny Olson. Thank you, friends. Good bunch. Good bunch there and a good bunch here. We got a new kid on the block.
Yes.
And I hope you'll all join me. A little applause as I welcome her.
She's young enough to be your granddaughter.
I'm going to kiss her anyway. You know about the tradition here.
No, but I guess I'll learn.
Yes.
Oh,
well, you have
you
to be
learn.
Properly welcomed by the star of the show. Why are you backing off?
Well, I told her I was the star of the show. My fault. No, he's really the star. He just wants to give you a kiss.
Just a simple little welcome kiss. Nothing fancy.
Watch it!
Watch it. Welcome, Helaine Lembeck.
What?
I said, am I now not new anymore?
Now you are no longer the new kid on the block.
But you've got lipstick on.
Oh, have I? Well, throw me up the stairs. Look at Roger sitting there. Roger.
Tissue. Roger.
Are you paying attention, Roger?
No, he's not.
Roger's father's here.
His father's in town.
Yes.
Roger's father's here.
How's
that?
Beautiful.
Thank you very much. All right. Now let's all say hello to our current champ, Lori Smith. Applause, applause, applause. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good. I want to tell you about another tradition, Lori. No, I'm only kidding. Lori has $5,700. Wow. And she's going to have a go at another big whack of money, right?
Right.
Just as the time expired last time, she won the game, and that means you're going to start with the audience match, the whole thing, right?
Right.
Ready for it?
Sure.
Good. We'll do that right after we do this for you. Lori Smith here. Now let's see how much more she will win. She could win over $5,000. Not too long ago, we polled a studio audience and we said you write down your best answer to this. Talk to blank. Now if you match the answer they gave us most often, you get $500. For matching their second most popular response, you get $250. And for matching the third, you get $100. And three of the six ding-a-lings are going to help you.
Richard?
Something Brett does after a couple of toddies.
Yes.
She talks to the animals.
Talks to the animals. That was a wonderful song.
Brett, talk to... I have a couple. Let me see if I have anything.
Yeah, one is over there and one is over there.
She's thinking. Oh, what Charles always does. He talks to the trees.
I talk to the trees.
The trees.
Yes.
Charles.
Charles, she called on you for the third position.
Talk to the vegetables.
Oh, yes. Oh, how easily we forget.
What?
The song we both sang as leading men on Broadway in Bye Bye Birdie.
What?
Talk to me.
Talk to me.
How fast we forgot.
Buddy will be very happy for that plug.
I think it was a hard song, remember?
Yes, it was a very difficult song. It was the ballad in the show. Okay, now you've got talk to the animals, talk to me, and talk to the trees. What was that?
I just remember, I thought
no,
probably...
people are jealous when they didn't sing that hit song.
I've never heard of it.
You've never heard the song?
How did it go, my love? Let me hear
it. Sing a little.
No, you don't have to. Get our record.
I remember you have the option here of choosing one of those or giving us...
Yeah. I have his record, and there's some very unsavory things on it, I might add.
You have the option of choosing one of those or giving us one of your own, Lori.
I'll go with Talk to the Animals.
Talk to the Animals. Rex Harrison sang that, good one. If I could talk to the animals. All right, let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Talk to yourself.
That's how our record sold.
Yes, we do a lot of that around here. May we see the next one, please? Talk to the Animals. Congratulations, you've got it. Well, I don't know what's going to be on top. What do you think, John? Talk to the trees, talk to the moon,
Get ready to get on me in case it's trees.
Okay. Ari, slide it.
Back to me. Right. Written by Charles Strauss and Lee Adams.
Charles Buddy Strauss and Lee Adams.
No, we don't sing like that. We're not gig players from Vegas. This is not Charo you're looking
for. Now, Laurie, you've got another $250. Means you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500. You have to match one celebrity exactly in order to collect.
Richard, please.
Okay, Richard, here we go. Good luck to you. Laurie, it's worth $2,500. Goes like this. Blank rag, R-A-G, blank rag. Blank rag. Now, what answer would you like to give us, which you think will match his and gain you the additional $2,500?
The only thing I can think of is dish rag.
Dish rag. Are you a housewife?
No.
You're not. You never touch the stuff? I said, are you a housewife? She said, I never touch the stuff. Dish rag. Dish rag is what she said, Richard.
I was thinking of another tune.
What was that?
You can't think of it?
Oh, Tiger Rag. Yes, that's a wonderful whole
Written
that tiger.
By Bob Dish.
Dish. Congratulations, Laurie. You now have $8,450. Laurie Smith, a big winner here. $8,450. How do you feel?
Oh, fantastic.
Okay, let's meet your new challenger now. Let's all welcome Maggie Flecksteiner. Hello, Maggie.
Hi.
We welcome you, Maggie Flecksteiner.
Thank you.
Ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself before we begin.
I'm married and I have three boys, and I'm a secretary for a large medical group in La Habra, and I like to bowl and water ski.
You live in La Habra?
I live in Whittier.
In Whittier?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, good luck to you here, Maggie. We'll begin by asking you to make a selection here. Nope. You really want to do the commercial? I mean, it's definite. All right. You're not toying with me, are you? Because if you want to do the commercial, I'll do it. I don't care. All right, do a commercial. What the hell? Now, we're ready to carry on, and we'll ask Maggie to make a selection here. You may have A or B, Maggie.
A.
All right. This is the game.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Say, did you hear about Nerdo Crumbesia's presidential limousine?
No.
Would you like to hear about it?
Yes. Yeah.
It's a blank with four tires on it.
Oh.
Nerdo Crumbesian presidential limousine is a blank with four tires on it.
Cute. Well, not...
All right.
Come here, Han.
Is he molesting you?
Yes, nicely.
You. Oh, nicely. Good. All right. Brett is trying to learn how to spell something or something up there. What's going on?
He's a married man.
Not for long if I have my way. Oh, darling.
Okay, Maggie. The presidential limousine of Nerdo Crumbesia is a blank with four tires on it.
A bathtub?
I think that's a funny answer. She said a bathtub with four tires on it.
My goodness.
That's Finland, isn't it?
Oh, Finland, yes.
Yeah. I was thinking of something a little raunchier, a coffin.
A coffin with four tires on it. All right, that's neat.
Now, yes. I couldn't think of the answer I wanted, so I asked.
Yeah.
And grave error.
Did he help you?
Sure he did. Wait till you see it.
She may have the women.
What are those things, like the little kids going to go...
Skateboard?
No. You know better than his. Those things, and they have... Dickie knows those little things, and they have braces, and they have little wheels.
Go-karts.
Right.
Go-kart.
This is what he told me. Scooter.
Scooter. That's
scooter.
That's a match, isn't it,
Diana? You just thought he said scooter.
Oh, I love it so much. I can't live without it.
What do you say?
Well, if you would remember what's on the Trumbo Crumbresia, whatever the...
Nerdo Crumbresia.
Nerdo Crumbresia flag.
Right.
On a field of blue is a garbage can.
A garbage can. Garbage can with four tires on it. Maggie, so far we don't have a bathtub. Can you give this little girl a bathtub?
No, I thought he'd be a little gauche and out of the ordinary, and I said house.
A house. It's a house with four tires on it. See how hard it is? Richard?
I personally think it's a cut above scooter. I think you're okay.
Thank you.
No, I said a garbage can.
A garbage can with
very
four
rare
tires on.
Collector's
yes.
item.
Right. Air conditioned.
Collector's item.
A collector's item, yes. You must speak up, Richard.
Hello.
Hello.
Now we come to Miss Betty's answer.
I came within that of saying it was the first thing I thought of was bathtub, and then I thought, well, no, that's it. Garbage can.
Garbage can it is, so there you are. Now let's see what we've got for Laurie Smith here. Fred said, Larry is a real coward. When I challenged him to a duel, I said, pick your weapon. And he picked blank. Fred said, Larry's a real coward. When I challenged him to a duel, I said, pick your weapon, and he picked blank.
I love my answer.
Good.
I finished.
Remember, it's show business, Dick.
Yes, that's true.
Good, good, good. Okay.
Cute, sweetheart.
Laurie, ready?
No.
Here we go. Fred said, Larry is a real coward. When I challenged him to a duel, I said, pick your weapon. And he picked blank.
Baseball bat. I can't think
of it. A baseball bat. Would a coward pick a baseball bat?
No.
No?
A baseball bat.
A baseball bat. I don't think...
That's a little...
That's a cowardly move, yes.
Well, evil wouldn't tell you about that.
Especially when the other guy's got what?
He's got marshmallows.
Marshmallows, see? You're right, you know. The coward would take the baseball bat, while the dummy would take the marshmallows. What have you got?
He said, listen, step outside and I'll smack you with my powder puff.
Oh! Oh! What are you saying?
When I was a kid, we had stick balls, Gene.
Stick balls.
You know, not baseball bats.
Right.
So I chose...
Feather duster.
Feather duster. Coward would choose feather duster, wouldn't he? Helaine, what do you say?
Well, I chose it sometimes my father does to my mother, and that is his stomach.
Now, wait a minute. When I challenged
you,
I said, pick
your
weapon, and he picked...
Stomach.
How do you... Oh, I see. Oh, yes, of course. Now, cut that out.
Just trying to help.
Yes, well, you helped me more than you helped him.
You certainly know how to show an old game player a good time. Thank you. Marshmallows?
Marshmallows, yes. Cowards would do that. Now, what does Miss Gyration of 1978 say?
A feather.
A feather. Yes, cowards would do that. White feathers especially. So there we are at the end of round one, and we ain't got no score. I hope you ladies will score. Later. Right now, we've got this for you. Ah, stop that now. Okay, let's plow on ahead of here, ladies. Maggie, A or B?
A.
A it is. She didn't match anybody in the first round, so it means everybody has a go at it. 102-year-old Weird Willie is so weird.
Oh, what a good group.
I'll tell you, yeah, you're all right. He uses polygrip to keep his blank on. He's weird. 102-year-old Weird Willie.
102-year-old
Weird Willie. He uses polygrip to keep his blank on.
Good girl.
Wrong, but you.
Wonderful.
That's a sin.
Wonderful. Okay, Maggie. 102-year-old Weird Willie is so weird he uses polygrip to keep his blank on.
His wig on?
His wig. She said wig.
Of course she would. Look at her. No,
that's a beautiful one.
I say that he wouldn't. He would be past worrying about his wig.
Oh.
He uses a polygrip to keep his shorts on.
Shorts on. Well, that's better than...
Conjures up all kinds of pictures.
Better than nailing a man. What do you say?
I say at 102, you shouldn't be worried about your shorts either. No, no. I said rug.
Rug.
Oh, there was one hand, Maggie.
You mustn't take personal offense, Charles.
I didn't. Only my hairdresser knows. So there. Hairpiece.
Hairpiece. All right. That's two for Maggie. Helaine, 102-year-old Weird Willie is so weird he uses polygreep to keep his blank on. Polygreep group.
His hairpiece.
Hairpiece. That a girl. That's three for Maggie. She's rolling along pretty good there.
Little fly has just arrived.
Where? Wait a minute. Uh-oh.
It's Vincent Price.
No. Where's the fly spotter?
Right to Richard.
It's backstage.
You don't
is
want
it really
to
backstage?
No, don't.
He's a perfectly good
he's
person.
He's terrible. He kills flies.
No, if I...
Betty would never kill him.
Get
no,
the fly spotter.
No.
Jack, get that fly spotter out.
No, there'll yes. be no more bloodshed.
If we get the fly spotter, you won't know where I'm going to hit you.
Show us your card, Richard.
Oh, show us your fly. I said hair.
Hair. A four.
I have an no, he's not here. There are no flies on me. You've heard that all over town. I have an uneasy feeling that I think the same way Dick Martin does, and that's an uneasy feeling.
Sure. I am worried.
Poor girl is in a heap of trouble. Now, let's see what we've got for Laurie here. You got to go to work here, Laurie. Match 4-5, 5-5. Norm said, our town hired the world's worst rainmaker. He didn't get it to rain, but everybody in town had an uncontrollable urge to blank. Our town hired the world's worst rainmaker. He didn't get it to rain, but everybody in town had an uncontrollable urge to blank.
Oh.
Okay. Here we go. Norm said our town hired the world's worst rainmaker. Now, he didn't get it to rain, but everybody in town had an uncontrollable urge to blank.
Tinkle.
Tinkle. Yeah.
You're going to turn it into that kind of a show. I said to drink.
To drink.
Yes
right.
Thirsty.
Made everybody thirsty.
See how they love me?
Yeah, they love you. In Peoria, you'd be terrific. What do you say?
Sure. And they didn't need the rainmaker
just hold
anymore.
It up. That's
Tinkle.
Right. That's it. Okay, Chuck.
Wee wee.
Wee wee. Score is now 4-2. She needs two more to achieve a tie. Helaine, what have you got?
Well, I thought I'd help her out.
All right. 4-3 score. One more to tie. And there's a tie. One more to win. Betty?
Oh, I'm in that seat again.
Well, it's a tie right now.
It's a terrible place to be Tinkle.
Yeah. Okay. Come on down here now. We'll say goodbye to Maggie Fletchsteiner. Pleasure to meet you. We have some gifts for you. And now we've got these messages just for you. Hello there. Well, how was it your first day out here?
I made it through.
Well, now, we enjoyed having you. Did you have a few laughs here?
Of course.
You know, you don't get paid. I'm not kidding.
It doesn't matter. We have so much fun, I don't need money.
Oh, thanks.
Now, do I get to come back?
Perfect person.
No, you are going to get paid. And you are all going to come back and watch Match Game 78 next time we get together, whatever day that may be, and I thank you. Don't give me 10 seconds. I'm finished now. Go to black.